Hi friends, welcome to RHEL Commands course video series presented by Narendra from Do with Python Technologies. In this video, we are going to see basically what is a command. Then we will see some simple commands. Okay, so let me go with very first concept, that is, what is a command? See, command is nothing but a specific instruction given to a computer or computer application to perform some kind of task. See, we are giving instruction to your computer, or sometimes we install some application on computer, right? So for that also we can give some instruction. So in order to use that instruction or to perform your task, we are giving commands. Okay, and generally these commands we are executing on command line. Suppose if you go and check on your Windows operating system, right? Suppose this is your command line for your Windows operating system. The same command line for your RHEL or Unix-like systems is called terminal. Of course, that is also command line, but that is called terminal. See, let me show my RHEL terminal. So this is my RHEL server terminal. Okay, then what is the use of this commands? Guys, generally in real time we are having servers in remote location. Now in order to access your server or in order to do some task on your server, your terminal or your command line is helpful. Okay, when it is helpful means whenever if you execute some commands on your command line or terminal, then that command line is helpful or the terminal is helpful. So finally, the terminal with commands is helpful in order to work with your remote servers. Okay, now here the commands are executed, okay, on terminal or command prompt. So we know that command prompt is nothing but generally for Windows operating system, and terminal for your RHEL servers or Unix like operating system. For them we are calling that as terminal. Okay, there are so many commands based on our required task. Suppose if you want to create some folder, okay, generally folder is called directory on Unix like operating system. Purpose is same, but in Windows operating system we are calling folder. That folder on Unix like systems is called as directory. Suppose in this entire video series we are going to work with RHEL terminal, I mean RHEL server. Okay, now different task means, suppose if you want to create some directory, then you require some different command. That is one task. In order to remove that, that is one task. In order to create a file, that is one task. So based on your required task, there are so many commands. Okay, as of now I am going with very simple commands, that is pwd. Very first one is pwd, means present working directory. Suppose you opened your terminal, right? This is your RHEL server terminal. Where you are, in which path you are having. Suppose, see, I am opening my Windows operating system folder as of now. So this is, suppose if you open some drive, okay, so this is your path. Now you are under this location, right? Under this location, this is in the GUI mode. The same way you can work on even RHEL GUI mode. Suppose this is the path. Now through terminal, I mean through command, if you want to know where you are, okay, then the simple command is pwd. You are under root, present working directory or current working directory. Okay, now that is very simple command. Then next command I am going with cd. Change directory means change path. So from one location to other location if you want to go, then how you can go through commands. Now with the help of cd you can move from one path to different path. Suppose I am moving into, first you have to provide your command, then your path. Suppose opt is one of my path on my operating system, okay, on my RHEL server. Now in order to move into that folder, that directory, that location, to that path, I need to use cd command, cd that path. Then if you enter, now you are under root opt. Now if you want to know now where you are, just execute pwd. Now you are under opt. Okay, now if you want to come back to your previous path, then if you know that path, directly you can give cd root. Otherwise, simply use cd space hyphen so that you will come back to your previous path. That's it. Okay, or suppose now I am going to cd root opt. Now I am giving enter. Suppose if I enter cd dot dot, again you are coming back to, observe here, root symbol. Okay, cd dot dot means just come back one path, come back to one level. Suppose let me go to some different location, there you can able to understand this very clearly. I am moving into some location. Then so as of now, suppose I am under root etc. Don't worry about this command. Now I am moving into some sysconfig location. Now observe here, pwd. Now you are under root etc sysconfig directory. So to know that, you are executing pwd command. If you want to come back one path back, one level back, then just simply type cd dot dot. Okay, now enter your pwd command where you are under etc. So basically your complete path etc sysconfig, right? If you come back up to etc, because one path, one level back, then for that, in that case, just use cd dot dot. Okay, and in order to clear your terminal, whatever you are executing, you are doing some task. Now, in order to clear your terminal, just use command clear. Okay, now I am giving just cd, then root. That is the root symbol. Now observe here, pwd, where you are under root. Okay, now you are under home root, complete root. Now see, I am going to execute ls, means list the content in the current path. So as of now, our current path is root. Observe here, this is our current path, right? Under root you are there. Now there, if you execute ls command, what are the files and directories are there, all it will display. So as of now, you are having only two in files you are getting. Okay, now instead of that ls command, you can also provide some path. Instead of listing the contents in the current directory, in the current path, if you want to know the in the different location content, then ls space path for that. So as of now, under root opt, we don't have anything. Let me go to root opt. I'm creating some empty file. So to create empty file, touch command is required. Touch my file dot txt. Okay, now I am coming back to root. Now under root I am having, now I am going to give ls space some path. That path is root opt. Now observe, you are able to get that file information. That means in the current location, from the current location, if you want to know the different location path information content, what are the files and directories are there, then you can execute your command space that path, ls space path, where you want to list the content. So that's it. So guys, this is just very simple commands, pwd, cd and ls. Okay guys, thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe my channel so that you will get notifications whenever you post some videos. If you have any queries, you can comment on the below of this video, or you can also drop a mail to do with python@gmail.com. Okay, bye.